Welcome to episode 2 of the second season of Leaders Mindset, a talk show through which CCA aims to bring some riveting conversations along with stories of commitment, hard work, dedication and success to inspire the youth. I am Shobhik Pal, senior member at Center for Cognitive Activities. Today, for our episode, we have Mr. Lenin Raghuvanshi sir. He is a Dalit rights activist, political thinker, social entrepreneur. He is one of the founding members of PVCHR, People's Vigilance Committee on Human Rights, which works for the upliftment of the marginalized section of the society. His work has been recognized with several national and international awards. Throughout our conversation, we have discussed some interesting aspects of how he worked for the social cause, for the upliftment of the people. Hope you enjoy the video.
We at CCA aim at bringing up conversations that matter and bring a change in our daily lives. Throughout this series of episodes, CCA is here to share stories of hard work, dedication, commitment, and motivation. So today I am here to introduce a speaker, Mr. Lenin Raghuvanshi. He is a Dalit right activist, political thinker, and social entrepreneur. He is one of the founding members of PVCHR, People's Vigilance Committee on Human Rights. He has been awarded with several awards like Gwangju Human Rights Awards 2007, ACHA Award in the year 2008, the International Human Rights Peace of the City of Wembanyama in the year 2010. A warm welcome to you, sir, on our show.
Yes.
Sir, so as you belong from a family of freedom fighters, so I would like to know, how were your childhood days?
It's very different, very diverse, and it is thanks to my family, because I have the diverse. My grandfather was freedom fighter, and yes, he was Gandhian and very down to earth. My father is also very down to earth, but he is very different opinion, because he is communist and he believe in a very different ideology. And my mother is a libertarian, but my grandmother was very hardcore Sanatani, and so she belongs to Sanatan Dharmas and Sanatan religions and the values. So there is a big dialogues on the table of dinners, especially between my father and grandfather. But it gave me a lot of thought, opportunity to thought process, to rethink about the situation. Another hand, because I belongs to a upper caste family, so I learn a lot of things from there also. But my grandfather put a lot of fingerprints on my mind, so I'm very much convinced with him, and also my grandmother. So that influenced my thought process, that influenced my understanding, and for that reasons, because I learned the stories from my grandfathers, how my family sacrificed in 1857, and how my grandfather did, and his uncle, the uncle of my grandfather, went to 10 years for the imprisonment, and also his wife. When I was child, also I learned from my uncle, who sacrificed his life as a miser with the war with the Pakistan. So in this way, one hand we are very much fighting, but I'm very much convinced with the non-violence struggles, and that is very, very important for my next of my life.
Sir, actually, being from a freedom fighter family is very much lucky. We can't forget what they have done for the nation, actually. So, yeah. Thank you, sir.
But it is also burden, I will tell you. It is also the burden sometimes, because if you don't care, you don't have the values, it is different. But it is also the burden how to sustain those values and those spirit in this country, because India, emerging nation states. India is very old civilizations, very old culture, but emerging nation states. And it is important to how to contribute the families of the freedom fighters in the real sense with the same spirit to build this nation state more stronger, more feasible.
Thank you, sir. That was a great answer from you. So now moving on to the next question we are having. Sir, at a very decisive age of yours, you had two choices in front of you. either to be one of those who are learning from the ancestral knowledge of medicine and working for its betterment to serve the society, or to work over the social plagues that have affected modern India and have left behind a transcript of injustice, discrimination, and atrocities of a part of a society. You had the opportunity to serve either of the two, but you have chosen to tackle and fight for the latter one. Sir, can you please explain?
Yeah, you look in the Ayurveda, where in the Indian medicine, I learned Indian medicine, modern medicine, and surgery. So it is a great opportunity in the Gurukul Kangadi Ayurvedic College. But most important thing, Ayurveda gave the theory of the community medicine, which is also developed in the modern medicine. When I went to my hospital as a house job, observer, resident medical observer, my superintendent asked about the corruption money. So I thought, oh my God, one hand I become a doctor and then I'm going to support corruption. This is the one life. Another life already I influenced by my grandfather, especially. And I decided I'm not going for the any political thought process, means any political parties especially. So that is, I'm very much convinced about that. So most important things, because I'm born in upper caste family, I am a man, and I have all privileges. So it is my duty and the job and the responsibility and the accountability to eliminate the situation of the discrimination, injustice and all. And in this way, that is going to support. So, and if you look in the later, I develop a testimonial therapy. It is a brief narrative therapy we are going to discuss further. And so I use the knowledge of medicine. My mind with the medicine, I want, just like the caste system in the patriarchy, diagnosis is so important for a doctor. So I'm always believe in diagnosis, but the treatment, I'm very convinced we need to be give the non-violence and the democracy based on the pluralism and diversity. So this is the tough time. My mother's spell out from my family because she is a mother, and she was not convinced with me what I decided. But my life partner Shruti went along with me, and we decided to work for the society. And no funding is coming, then I'm going to also use for some time for my medicines. But I'm fortunate because funding is there, resources is there. And after 5 years, my parents started to support me. And they gave the house, they gave the a lot of resources to me.
So, actually, the support from family is very much important. You are lucky enough that you got the support.
Yeah. And I'm also convinced because my mother, 5 years gave the out from families because she is so much concerned about my livelihoods and other things. So that is very natural. And people need to be understand balance between practice and the idealism.
Okay, sir. Thank you, sir. Next, we have turning one's motive into a reality is not a cake work. You turned your zeal to help into mass campaign and reach milestones that are even visible to narrow eyes. How did it all sum up and work out into an organization like PVCHR? As we mentioned, PVCHR.
The most important thing before the PVCHR, my internship was fantastic because I work with the United Nations Youth Organization. I convince I'm not going for any political parties. So, because big fight with my grandfather and my father, so I decided no. Both wanted to me compel to their political party. So, and in this way, I worked with Kailash Satyarthi, who received the Nobel Peace Prize, and I learned a lot of things. And because if you look the child labor issues, it is very very important. To provide the educations to the children and the livelihoods and the lands and other things to the parents. And for that reasons, I went formed this organization, People's Wilderness Committee on Human Rights. And nowadays it is 72,000 members, a lot of staff and the people. And but it is like a Gangaji, if you are going like a mother river Ganga. Gangaji is so narrow that time in the start, in the Bhagat, in the Gomukh. But when she is coming to the Kolkata and the Sundarban area, she become very wide because many streams, many things are. So nowadays, PVCHR is, I'm one of the founding member, but the PVCHR is also the hard work of the hundreds of the and thousands of the volunteers and the staffs and the members. So it is the whole concept of the how to create the hope for the people and also create a platforms where the free thinking and the space. So and that is, if you are walking anything continuously with the determination, with the passion, you are going to create something very differently in the future. After all obstacles, after all propaganda against you, you are going to create that.
Sir, your idea has been now followed by 1,000 people. As you mentioned, 72,000 members are there. It was your idea and it is followed by so many. That's great, sir.
Yeah. It is not my idea. It is what I learns from our work and also from our history, and especially the history of Banaras and diversity, pluralism. And you look the Mahadev, Lord Mahadev, 3,000 years before, 5,000 years before, like a Veda time is 5,000 years before. So Mahadev did his love marriage in the world first time, and he fought with the Dutch Prajapati. So it's a very different concept I learned from history. And so we have a lot of we are fighting against cognitive weaknesses, cognitive problems, but we are also adhere with the our cognitive glories, successful things, the values which is important for humanity. So it is my learning, what I learned from the history, from our works, and also from the people. So Lalin Raghubansi is not an individual. Lalin Raghubansi is a what I learned from the soil of this country.
Sir, thank you, sir. Sir, as you mentioned, your journey has a lot of challenges and obstacles. What was the motivation that kept you moving in this path? Means to overcome all the hurdles, you are here.
My grandmother always praying. And in the village, there is no electricity. And when she pray in the night, especially, she told you, look, the candles, a small, this diya and the candle has a lot of powers to break the darkness of the dark time. And from there, I learned hope is so important. And you need to be light yourself as a candle. And you learn yourself. And obstacles and the problems is the part of that. Sometimes I'm frustrated, especially when my family uncles, who was a mafia and who gave the death threats to my son. So, and my son is never involved into that. My son was a snooker player. He's a modern guy, very different from me. And he never worked with me. So that time I'm frustrated. So obstacle is a part of that, because you look, if there is no obstacle, it means you are not working very well. And but the thing is that there is a spirit and the jill for the hope. We are going to win. We'll still overcome someday. And that understanding is always forced me to continue our work.
So, sir, next question we are having. We call ourselves a democratic country. But even today, there is a small element of discrimination present in each and every section of the society. How, according to you, we can eliminate the devil inside ourselves? And as a common people, how can we contribute in eliminating the discrimination which is prevalent in a society?
You know, very important thing. Every day we are taking the bath. We also clean our home. But when we are taking the bath, we are not, we clean our dirt. And when we also cleaning our home, we are not throwing everything from the home, only the dirt. So it is most important things. We are very old civilizations. We are very old culture. We are very old society. So we have many big problems because we have a lot of dirts. And for that reason, we need to be critical. But critical is not means you are going to throw everything. So you need to analyze what is good for humanity and for our society, especially the caste system, patriarchal understanding, sexism, and communal understanding is not going to help our society at all. So look, on the basis of the religion, we form a country like a Bangladesh, and after that the Pakistan, and then Bangladesh. But the problem of the Pakistan is very differently because foundation is not good at all. Country is never going to found on the basis of the religion at all. Otherwise, whole Arab is one. One Europe is one on the basis of the religion. It is not going to happen. Nation state always is going to base on the values, and values is the justice, liberty, fraternity, dignity to everybody, provide the opportunity to everybody, which is very important. And for that reason, we need to understand what is the dirts we have due to these civilizations and our thought process. So always correct ourselves, learn ourselves, de-learn many things.
So as we know that schools and colleges form a major part of the society. So we have several awareness programs and campaigns which are being organized in the institutions, but still youth lacks a lot of enthusiasm towards social causes. How do you think we can restructure the educational institutions can be improved to bring a change? Means, how can the educational system be restructured to give an idea about social cause? Yes, sir.
Yeah, you look, India has never incorporated the idea of Gandhiji. Gandhiji's talk about the Bunyadi Taleem, Bunyadi Shiksha, the basic education. German education system, we need to learn from German education system. They implemented the idea of Gandhi. Just like someone want to become a carpenter, someone want to become a nurse, someone want to become a anything, and then they want to join upper education, they will join anytime. So first we need to reform this and also link with the society, because without understanding the society, develop the arts to understand the society. Someone is going to become engineer, like from your institute, very premier institutes. And so engineer need to understand what is the societal problem, what is the historical and cognitive problem, what is the contextual problem. And for that reasons, they need to be organize programs, interaction with the society, because it is an art. Life is an art, so they need to understand the knowledge, attitudes, and the practice. So if the engineers on the dam, it's a dam, making a dam, so they have the capacity to map out the knowledge, attitudes, and the practice of those people who is affected by the dam. So how to create a social project for them, how to integrate to them into the establishment of the small dams, like that. Any projects, engineering project, any medical projects, any work of the IS officer, any work of the IFS officer, any work of the PCS officers, any officers, any, always linked with the society. So if we are going to give 10 to 20% parts of the educations to how to learn the society, how to learn the history of this country, how to learn the problems and solve the problem, then it is very different. Then engineer is also going to contribute. Doctor is also going to contribute. So we don't need to become a full-timer like me. Every doctors, every engineers, also the social entrepreneurs. And they will contribute and learn with the society, not the conflict with the society. They understand how to articulate, how to create their solutions. And for that reason, it is very decentralized, what the Gandhiji's ideas. And not only everything is going to decide by the cabinet ministers and the prime ministers and the chief minister of this country. We need to give them power through the education of the social work, and also give the powers to the engineers and the doctors and the government officials, especially the implementers of the our policies and the schemes and the programs. They will work directly with the governments, directly with the panchayat, directly with the village council, and it is also important. So it is very important. And you look the different countries, so-called developed countries, they provided the internships. They pay for that volunteership. They pay for their air tickets and their accommodations. So government of India and also the corporates, responsible corporate in this country, they need to be provide a fund and the programs, flexible programs, where they use the engineers, doctors, and as a leap year, and spend with the society and understand our society, and create some solutions before become the full-time engineer and full-time doctors, full-time officials in this country.
Sir, it is quite true that the power in our country is accumulated to a certain sections of the society and is not distributed.
Yeah, but because we need to empower implementer very differently. We need to pay good enough to them, and also during the educations provide the opportunity they will learn and develop this art how to interact with the society.
Thank you. Next, we have, as the coordinator of People's SAARC, how do you think the formation of South Asian People's Forum has helped in uplifting the human rights?
Yeah, look, it is a People's SAARC. SAARC is a governmental body of the South Asian governments, and they are headquartered based in the Kathmandu. In the 2005, we organized the first People's SAARC, not supported by any donor agency. 7,000 people came together, and participants from the Afghanistan, like a second in command of the RAWA, Revolutionary Afghani Women Association, and the Nida Ali from Human Rights Commission of Pakistan, and Arup Rahi, who is a very famous Sufi singer nowadays from the Locos, Bangladesh, and the Darin Gunsekra from the Viroj Lok Institute from Sri Lanka, and the 30 participant came from the Nepal, with the support of INSEC Nepal. And I will tell you, it is very, very important for us. We talk and we declare the South Asian People's Declaration. And after that, People's SAARC become a fashion and this a phenomena supported by many donor agencies and the publics they organize. But that time, we will give a South Asian People's A declaration, which is very important. One important thing to include the Afghanistan in South Asia, so which happened. And also we talk about the democracy. So SAARC also gave a charter on the democracy in 2011. And nowadays we are fighting for South Asian human rights mechanism, because many problem of the fishermen and other problems links with the South Asian problems, just like the problem of minorities. Situation of minorities are very human rights of the minorities are very pathetic in South Asia, in Bangladesh, Afghanistan, and emerge of the fascism in the South Asia, terrorism in the South Asia, how to influence the human rights. So nowadays we also have the online petition on the formation of South Asian human rights mechanism. And this is very important, because I learned from the European Union, the whole foundation of the European Union on the need of the people and the defeat of the free trade of the Britain. And this European Union also create instruments, a system, a platform, which eliminate the permanent war between France and Germany. Before the European Union, there is a big fights between on the border, France and Germany, what we are facing on India and Pakistan. So for that reason, South Asian human rights mechanism is very, very important to create a South Asian people's movement for the South Asian secular and the democratic South Asia. This is very, very important because also in the partition of the India and Pakistan, many people are faced, there is no reconciliations, there are no confession, but people have there a lot of bad memories in their hates and their hurts, and also the young people learn from their family members. We need to also create the reconciliations and the confessions the people face due to the partition, so which is also important to understand, because sometimes the cognitive memories of the human rights violations also creates problems for the democracy, and also to help the organized violence and the terrorism. So it is also important for the peaceful South Asia, South Asian human rights mechanism need to be created on the SAARC level. And already there is a human rights institutions in the South Asia. They also come together and to discuss their learnings and their perspective also. So South Asian people's movements create a concept of the people SAARC, and also the philosophy and the instrument which is still influencing human rights struggle and democratic struggle of South Asia.
Okay, sir. The pandemic has hit every section of the society. So we would like to know, how was your work affected and what were the challenges you faced since last year?
Yeah, look, because our all staff, when I came from hospital, we did the antibody test. Almost all 100% staff had developed their antibody. It means everybody faced the infection. Many people died. My one staff died, Sripratap Chaube. So we lost him. We lost also some relatives of our staff. So it is painful. But it is a challenge, and we need to save humanity. So we supported migrants in the first lockdown, and also the marginalized community. And here also we are some we have a lot of human rights violations, but very less humanitarian support. But after the pandemic, we started to provided a lot of humanitarian support, just like we provided nearly hundreds oxygen concentrators to the government hospitals, and also we created many places oxygen bank, means through the concentrator when the communities and the doctors need that on the charitable level. Also we provided a lot of organized community kitchens, and provided the foods to the people. Also recently, we provided with the Embassy of New Zealand, we provided the vitamin D and the nutritious food to the 2,000 children of the Musars and the Dalits. So, and 350 mothers and the pregnant women, we provided the nutritional foods. Also, we provided mask and sanitizers and other things, not to the our worker, as well as also to the government of nurses, doctors, ENM, Aganwadi workers. Everybody is not going to pay so much money. This is also important. And also when I came back from the life payback, so I distributed a lot of hundred thousands of the rupees to the my staffs and to different people, because it is also important everybody have the sufficient funds to work about that. Also we provided 1,200,000 rupees I provided through my business, family business, to Chandra Mishra, and who is working for the beggar, upliftment of the beggars. They want to convert beggars into the social entrepreneurs. Also, he is working for the unemployment free Banaras. So that is very different. So a lot of humanitarian supports, direct support, paybacks to society. And I'm also part of the a committee led by Salman Khurshid, advised by Priyanka Gandhi, about the violation of human rights during the second wave. So the report is coming. So I'm also busy into that.
Okay, sir. Sir, as the majority of our audiences are within the age group of early 20s, 21, 22. So any advice which would you have given to yourself at 20 years old, you would like to share with us?
One important thing, immediately start to become degender and de-caste, because then you are not going to, if you want to enjoyment in your life, you understand, develop the arts, how to interact with different castes, different perspective, and also with the women, especially boys, I'm telling, how to interact with the girls, make the friends, to talk with them, understand their perspective, respect their perspective. And the second important thing, diversity is very important. We need to learn how to respect to different opinion. And then you become very happier person, very successful person, because this is very, very important. Believe in yourself and stand with your convictions, but all conviction need to be support to humanity. So any job you are going to do, if you are going to do with the honesty, and you want to contribute with the nation states, then it is always going to link with social work. It is going to link with the social entrepreneurships. So every studies is going to contribute. We need multi-layer, multi-dimensional supports to create our nation state better and the world better. And for that reasons, no job, no work is the superior and inferior. So don't think about that. Dignity of labor is so important. Don't sacrifice your dignity, your opportunity, your hopes, and also don't create a threats to the dignity and hope and honor of other people.
Thank you, sir. That was a great piece of advice for everyone. So with this, we come to the end of our session. So it was an honor for me to host you, sir, personally. Thank you, CCA NIT Durgapur, for having you here. Hope that the motive with which we started this episode is successfully reached to our audiences. Sir, we wish to have you in our upcoming events. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you to CCA NIT Durgapur, and especially you and your friends. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.